You brought him back to me.
We told you we would.
John! What are you doing here?
It's good to see you too, partner.
I meant I hadn't sent for you yet.
I went.
But I said that.
Yeah, I know what you said. I felt different.
Is that so?
Yes.
And when Spring and John brings the law down on all of us, what then, Arthur?
Well, I guess we'll have another fight on our hands.
Loyalty, Arthur, it ain't. I had a goddamn plan! John, you are my brother. You are my son. I was coming for you.
They was talking of hanging me, Dutch.
They was talking. And now they may come and hang us all.
Arthur!
Oh, sorry. I was miles away, thinking of, I don't know.
Dutch said to tell you he and Mike have gone to Annisburg. Something about Mr. Cornwall.
Cornwall. Okay. Thanks, Mary Beth.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, he ain't done yet, Abigail. Dutch seems...
to have lost his mind? And no.
Just be careful.
I don't have to be careful. I have you as a friend.
Hey there. You okay?
No real reason.
Making trouble for those who deserve it always seemed reason enough for Dutch. Problem is, I ain't sure he cares who he's fighting.
We could really use some more meat, Mr. Morgan.
Can't kill everyone.
So.
Good. We really needed this.
What are you scheming about now, huh? Goddamn traitors. You. You were nothing but a street rat when he found you. He believed in you when no other son of a bitch would. Oh, and him?
Good job, Mr. Morgan.
You ain't been nothing but a bad apple from the start. You ain't even been with us a full year and you think you know better. And you? Well, you're the lowest of the lot. Ungrateful sons of bitches. All of you. You'll get what's coming to you.
Arthur, don't forget, I'm more than happy to craft you something if you bring me the right materials.
Thank you, Mr. Pearson. Come on, girl.
Hey, Arthur.
All right. Can we talk?
I don't have much to say to you right now.
Hey, Arthur.
Get the horse out of here.
Reverend. Can you speak?
Of course.
What's wrong? I'm frightened. I'm so very frightened. I cannot go on. How many more times will we survive? These past months have been hellish.
Dear sir, you were once very kind to Beau and myself, and it pains me to ask you to show us further kindness. But I have nowhere else to turn, and nobody else upon whom I can impose. I will, of course, pay you handsomely for your troubles. My family have turned quite mad and are threatening to send me away to stop my work, which they say is disgracing them. As if their history of absolute moral depravity, utter debauchery, and perpetual drunkenness did not disgrace them enough. I must escape, yet I am kept prisoner here. Can you help? Most days I am to be found at the cabins on the plantation. The main house and all it stood for are thankfully no more. Yours faithfully, Penelope Braithwaite.
Hey.
What the hell going on around here?
Hey.
Dutch is crazy as a cat, or fucking Bill will turn his walking to the screws on me. The only way this is going to end is with a big old
hole. Yep.
Hey, boys, it's one of them what hurt our kin.
Hey!
Christ!
That's what happened. Come on, the old friend.
Oh, shit!
He's one of them killers with a holler. You'll die good.
Shit!
here. Easy there, girl. Okay then, girl.
Giddy up.
Okay, then.
And go away now, please.
Will you please go away and bother somebody else?
You're all bastards, bastards, bastards. You're dead. Come outside! You're all bastards!
¡Suéltame!
¡Hey, hey!
¡Ayúdame! ¡Socorro! ¡Que alguien me ayude! ¡Señor! ¡Por favor! ¡Ayúdeme! ¡Me duele!
I got some medicine.
¿Medicina? ¿Ya para qué? No puedo.
Let's go, girl.
Our little adventure.
You all right there?
Who are you?
Oh, it's okay, ma'am. I don't mean you no harm.
Well, it makes no difference now. If an outlaw or a wild animal doesn't get me starvation, well... We came out here from the city in search of a different life. Something true, something real. All this squandering and indulgence, we wanted to strip it away, to find something authentic. What a pair of fools.
Train station or a town I can take you to?
No, I can't give up now. He wouldn't want that. I can't have it. I'm gonna do this for you, Cal.
Well, I'll leave you to it. Is there anything left for you to eat?
Nothing. Now, we didn't know the first thing about hunting. Couldn't even catch a darn mouse. If you need any poisonous berries, though, I'm a natural at finding those.
Well... you ain't gonna last much longer out here if you don't know how to hunt. Come on. I'll show you.
All right. But you better not try any funny business. You know, I may be weak, but I still know how to stand up for myself.
Oh, I don't doubt it. Come on. Tell me, you ever skinned an animal before?
No, but then again, I haven't caught much of anything either.
Well, you'll need to know how to do both if you're gonna survive out here.
I am all too aware. So where should we head for?
Let's try in the trees down there, near the river. What happened to your husband, if you don't mind me asking?
The bear got him. He was horrified. He survived, but only for a couple of days. I buried him a week ago.
I'm sorry.
This was really his dream more than mine. I'd have popped the next train back to Chicago if he'd said the word. But now... Look! A rabbit!
Just hold the legs tight, pull the skin away quickly. Should come right off.
Oh my! It worked.
That's all there is to it. You did good.
I think I've seen enough blood for one day. Do you mind if we head back now?
Sure. Walk you back. You did good. That should keep you fed for a few days.
Oh, yes. At least. Thank you so much.
I mean... It really ain't such a bad spot. You got a good water source, some moat. Survive here all right.
I have no doubt that one can survive here. Whether Charlotte Balfour can is a different matter entirely. You've probably lived your whole life in the outdoors.
Oh, a lot of it, that's for sure.
I barely left the city before coming here. Cal spent his summers growing up at his grandparents' lodge in Maine, but I get the impression they did more punting than hunting.
Right.
No, we're done for now. Whoa.
Come on, let's get you home.
Since we got here... Thank you. That was the first time anyone's done anything nice for us. For me. Since we got here.
Nature provides, but she sure don't always make it easy.
That she doesn't. I'd invite you in, but I'm dead on my feet, if you'll forgive the pun. Please do call again sometime, though. A good rest, and hopefully I'll be a new woman.
You take care, man.